Good morning and high five. High five. Let's come up a little bit higher with the things of God. We're talking about about the power of the blood of Jesus. And today I'm going to teach you something that I learned about what not to do. You know, I don't know if you realize this, but Harry Potter is advanced witchcraft. And I had a family that was into the Harry Potter big time. And I started covering the house of the blood of Jesus. I started covering, you know, the walls of the blood of Jesus in my prayer. You know, I started making much of the blood of Jesus. And you know what? Everything started to get worse. It got worse and worse and worse. I didn't think it could be worse, but it kept getting worse. And Alice Smith of U.S. Prayer Center of Houston was ministering at our church in Galveston, Texas. And she was ministering, I don't remember what she was ministering at, but right in the middle of her message, she stopped and she says, I'm going to read it to you from my book. Never cover the house with the blood of Jesus unless you cleanse it first, because it only torments the demons in the house and makes everything worse. Well, no wonder everything was getting worse. The demons were trapped inside. Now, so I started, you know, seeking the Lord, what to do, you know, how do I lift it? First of all, you lift it by just, it was applied in prayer, and so you lift it in prayer. And so that next 2 weeks, I had a confirmation from Dr. Sandra Kennedy in the healing school. Ken and I were doing healing school, and she talked about how she had made much of the blood, covered the church with the blood of Jesus and everything, because they were having so much turmoil in their church. And she got outside, she was so proud of herself, and she said, and then the Lord spoke to her and said, now what are you going to do? The demons are locked inside the church. See, the thing is, the devil and demons have no weapon against the blood of Jesus. And when you draw a bloodline or you cover something, they can't get out, but they can't get in either. You know, and so you have to know how to do it. And so the third witness was, I was listening to a cassette I had gotten from Elijah List from Graham Cook. And it was Enjoying Your Wilderness Experience. I've never learned how to enjoy my wilderness experience. But he gave a message about an experience that, you know, he would work in a barrio in Mexico for 16 hours a day, and then he would just come home, go to the cheap hotel that he was in, totally exhausted. And so when he went into his hotel room, he laid on the bed and he was so tired, and five big demons walked through the door, his hotel room door. And you know what? He looked at him and he says, oh God, I'm just too tired to deal with this. And he turned over and went to sleep. Now the next night, the same thing happened. On the third night, he was walking home from the barrio, and he said, Lord, are they going to come again? And the Lord said, yes, they're going to come again. And he said, well, what am I supposed to do? And the Lord told him, I'll tell you what to do. So when those five big demons walked through the door, the Lord told him, I want you to cover the ceiling, the floor, the walls, everything with the blood of Jesus. And he did that, and then he thought to himself, oh no, they're locked in here with me. And then the Lord said, turn on the worship music as loud as you can. He had a cassette worship tape that he was listening to, and he turned it up as loud as he could, and he said he almost busted his ribs laughing at the demons that were screaming, and they were bouncing off the walls because they could not get through the blood. 1 minute left for one more story, and then I want to tell you what I do. Alice Smith was on her TV show last year, and you know, I told her how much that just nugget had helped me and so many people that were not having great things in prayer, you know, great results. And she said, we might be doing something the wrong way. And she said her and Eddie found out really early in the ministry not to cover anything with the blood of Jesus unless you cleanse it first. There was a friend of theirs, I am totally running out of time. There was a friend of theirs that had an 18-month-old baby girl that all her organs were shutting down, and the doctors didn't know what to do about it. And so they went to pray for that baby, and they were praying, and Eddie said, wait a minute, we're not getting through, something's wrong. So they backed up, they started praying, and out of that 18-month-old baby's mouth said, lift the blood. And so they were shocked. that a man's voice came out as a demon's voice. And so what they did is in prayer, they said, we lift the blood of Jesus off of this baby. They cast the spirit out of that baby. See, the spirit could not get out because it was covered with the blood. And so it was what it was doing. It was killing all the organs so that he could get out. The demon could get out. And so and then they cast the demon out. They lifted the blood. They cast the demon out. And that baby girl started playing. And you know what? She's alive and she has grown children today. And so tomorrow I'm going to talk to you about what I do instead of covering with the blood of Jesus. Because the Bible never once tells you to cover with the blood of Jesus. But let me tell you, everybody is doing it and they're not getting a lot of good things happening. So I went way over time today, but that's kind of what I do. Love you. Bye-bye.